team is a program that knows about winning championships, producing legends on the field and on the sideline. Now, a lone star is set to lead the herd back to victory. And his name is Colt McCoy.
Say goodnight to this one, touchdown, Texas!
True champions aren't made by avoiding failure. They are made by responding to it.
Welcome back to a beautiful day here in Austin at Earl K. Royal Texas Memorial Stadium. College Football Saturday presented by KFC rolls on at the half, 28-14 Texas. Third quarter not far away. Bill Land, Dave Lapham. Exciting, entertaining first half. Baylor thinking, man, a play here or there would be a whole different outcome, though.
Yeah, there's no doubt. I mean, it was a game of streaks, you know. I mean, Texas goes up 14-0. Baylor ties it up. Texas jumps up 28-14. And a big part of it was turnovers. Here we have the Jake Lamar blitz on Colt McCoy, throws an errant ball. Chris Burke takes advantage, picks it off, takes it back inside the 10-yard line to about the 6 or 7-yard line. Short field for Baylor as a result of this interception. And who do you go to? Why not Robert Griffin in space? Babineau cannot make the play. And it's a touchdown. It's the 11th rushing touchdown of the season. Now, deflected off the hands of Kendall Wright. And it's picked off by Ryan Palmer. This becomes a pick six, only the second interception of the season for Robert Griffin. Struggled on the day, 3 of 11, including that interception for a touchdown. Big stat, third down. Texas converting very, very well at 6 for 9. Baylor struggling, 1 for 6. And the turnovers, Texas plus 1 in the turnover department, probably the biggest reason they're up at the half.
All right, thank you, Dave. As Texas and Baylor gear up here for the start of the second half, let's check in quickly with Jim Knox.
All right, Bill, just got...
All right, it has been a wild first half here in Austin. There is no question about that. And Texas kicks it off with Tucker and Baker bringing it back out of the end zone. And Baker hit hard and driven back. Oh, my, what a hit. Longhorns ready to start the second half as Baylor will be first and 10 from near their own 10. Let's take a look at the first half possessions here for Baylor in this game.
Well, they started off slowly, losing the ball on downs in the second possession, and here they came back with their 14 points after being down. Now the interception, that's the pick six. So they've been sporadic. I mean, it's been a game of streaks for the Baylor offense, and they need a little bit more consistency on a snap-by-snap basis.
The first to 10 at the 16, and a pass complete to Wright. And brought down for a loss on the play. That was Kendall, I believe, coming through. Thomas, a bigger part.
Yeah, Thomas makes a good hit in space in the open field. Off schedule for Baylor on this first possession. Longhorns, you see, first half stars. Griffin obviously ran the ball well. Struggled in the passing game a little bit. How about Cosmic? Six catches, yeah. Over 100 yards, a couple of touchdowns. Colt McCoy, good and bad. Three touchdowns, and then two interceptions. Very uncharacteristic, forcing things a little bit.
Little look in here, and it is complete. Fenty with the reception that time. Justin Fenty, a junior out of Denton, Texas. It's his sixth catch of the season. Babineau on the play, and it'll make it third down, and if they mark that 35. Baylor again looking to the sideline for the play. From the 21-yard line, opening possession second half for the Bears. Griffin on the run and out of bounds on the play.
The one thing that Art Briles does offensively doesn't get the reception to get a fresh set of downs, but Art Briles will stretch you horizontally by formation, stretch you vertically by throwing the football over your head. Art Briles makes you defend the entire football field.
Epperson, good protection for the punt. Shipley making the fair catch at the 25-yard line, and Texas will take over there. Let's take a look at the Longhorns' first half possessions and how they fared in this 28-14 lead for Texas.
Well, they got off to a great start. I mean, they're up 14-zip, a 9-play, an 11-play drive. That's strong. Then all of a sudden, here comes a turnover. You know, that slows things down. Then they go three and out. Miss a field goal, and then they finish with a touchdown interception again. Sporadic. They were streaky as well. Neither offense were consistent enough in terms of on a snap-by-snap basis to have either coaching staff totally pleased with that side of the football.
Yeah, even though Texas had a big edge in total yardage, turnovers and that type of thing, that'd be crazy. And Baylor breaks through with a defensive play here as Whitaker hit for a loss. Leon Freeman, the senior out of Vero Beach, Florida, with the tackle.
Whitaker grabs that face mask like he thought he got grabbed by the face mask, but Freeman does a good job coming up the football field, and he doesn't get the headgear. He just hits him high, wraps him up, takes him down. A little bit of a quasi club in that right hand, got a little damaged finger on that hand.
Second and 15 for the 20. McCoy for protection here, and he drills it. And close to a first down as Malcolm Williams, the redshirt freshman out of Garland, Texas, with the reception. We'll see who they spot the football as Burke covering.
Well, Williams is such a big body, 6'3", 218 pounds. I mean, his upside potential is off the charts. And he just presents himself as such a big target for Colt McCoy. What a safety blanket he's going to be.
First and 10 Longhorns on the play at the 35. Whitaker running strong. About 8 or 9 on that one. Jordan Lake, the stopper. Second and short coming up. First down markers brought to you by Overstock.com. Shop for the company that supports college football. Overstock.com at home with the O.
Bill Whitaker averaged just under 8 yards a carry in the first half. And you know, his first carry went for negative yards, but he's back on track. He's downhill on that one.
Whitaker again. Georgia's four dives across the 45. Should have the first down there for Texas.
Texas wants to get that running game reestablished. In the beginning of the football game, they had it rolling a little bit. Maybe got away from it somewhat. I know one of their big goals today is to impose their will at the line of scrimmage and get that ground game established.
First and 10. And Whitaker. Nice surge immediately and then stopped by the Baylor line at the 48-yard line. Trey Bryant, junior from Dallas out of Berkner High School.
When Baylor couldn't get anything done in their first offensive possession, go 1-2-3 and out, Texas feels like if they can take their first drive here in the second half, go the length of the football field and punch it in the end zone, go up 3 scores, it'll be a good place to be.
And you mentioned their entire quarterback's getting a hit. You need to protect Colton, of course. Then another reason to establish that running game. He escapes the defense here and takes a big blow as he goes ahead for a couple of yards near the 46-yard line of Baylor here. Pavlik and Hill combined for the sandwich.
Gilikowski leaves the football field with an injured left elbow. He had that elbow problem last year. Let's take a look at him as he basically gets his shoulder pads turned to the sideline and loses his edge, his corner. It made it too soft to corner. Leon Freeman takes advantage of it. Gilikowski, as he hits the field, injures that elbow.
Third and 2. McGee rumbles to the 40-yard line, and Jordan Lake makes the stop, and I think that message has gotten home so far, Dave, to this Texas offensive line that, hey, you need to reestablish yourselves and dominate this game.
Oh, there's no doubt, and Jordan Lake, I'm impressed with it as well, Bill. He is definitely the enforcer. People are comparing him to Van McElroy, who had a good career with the Raiders. And I'll tell you what, he wears red contact lenses, make himself even look a little bit more fierce out there. He wants to dim the sun, but this kid itches.
39 tackles the last 3 games. He's been big again today for Baylor. McCoy gets this one off the nick of time. Collins, touchdown, Texas. 40 yards on the play. burn Jeremy Williams.
And Jordan Lake immediately slapped his hands together in frustration. What you do is once you get the running game going, little play action pass, you put that ball in the belly and take it out of there. And the linebackers have to respect it, as do the safeties, and all of a sudden you can sneak somebody behind them. That's exactly what the Longhorns did. They mixed the run and pass very well, and they finished it with a long distance play action pass.
Hunter Lawrence for the PAT here for Texas as they come out and quickly take care of business, and the PAT is good. It is 35-14 as Collins gets his first TD reception of the year, and McCoy his fourth TD pass, matching a season high for a game.
Ran that little play action fake, put it in the belly of McGee, touchdown.
Bevo in a much better frame of mind right now.
That's a very systematic chew going on right there.
Had some halftime fajitas like we did.
They'll just grind you up.
Life is good here at Austin, but the Longhorns are winning. Baker and Lamar are deep here as Justin Tucker will kick it off. Texas up 35-14. Can Baylor respond? Now it becomes the big question. They're 14-0, tied it at 14, and then Texas a 14-point lead at the half. And the first score here, ooh, Baker stopped just shy of the 20-yard line. First and 10 there. Our Best Buy connection of the game is the last TD pass of the day for McCoy, his fourth.
Just poor technique played right there by Jeremy Williams. I mean, he just let Collins run right by him. There's no help. I mean, he's supposed to be, he can't let a receiver get deeper than he is on the football field. He was expecting help. It just wasn't there. A breakdown in coverage, absolutely capitalized on by Colt McCoy and Brandon Collins.
Griffin hands it off here, and not much doing on that running game as Texas, they've suffered some injuries up to it now in the defensive line. As Finley is stuffed a yard or two.
Colt McCoy now four touchdown passes, two interceptions on the day. His career high for interceptions. He had four against Kansas State last year here in Austin as the Wildcats upset the Longhorns. They did it 2 years in a row, actually, but not enough wins for Ron Princess. He's going to be moving on at the end of the year.
Texas will have Kansas next week against KU. Deep Geddes. Little bit overthrown as Geddes, another one of those speedsters, a junior out of Los Angeles, coming in with 26 receptions. He's covered by Blake Gideon there.
Geddes ran the fastest 400 meters in high school when he was a senior, fastest in the nation. And he competes on the Baylor track team. I mean, this guy can fly. He ran a 45.8 400 meters in high school. He's got some big, big upside potential to him.
Griffin, 5 of 15 for 73 yards, a touchdown and an interception so far. Facing a 3rd and 8 here as he scrambles out to the left. Back across his body and incomplete, looking for Thomas. Thomas White, I should say, and he'll have to punt it away here.
Well, Griffin rolling to his left, right-handed quarterback, tough on the out and up again, and it's the same play that the pass interference occurred on. And Griffin just knows that he put a little bit too much air on that football, and his completion percentage, he's really struggling in that regard. He was 3 for 11 in the first half, and he had the interception that went for a pick six from Palmer. So Coach Art Brown is trying to calm down a little bit over there.
Epperson averaged 48 yards a kick in the first half on two punts. Shipley, fair catch signal here, and does the job. Texas, good field position. We come back at the 35 and a comfortable lead. Back in Austin, Texas with a football again. First and 10 from the 35 for the Horns with a 35-14 lead. Third quarter action. Colt McCoy completes this one to Kirkendall, and he is stopped shy of the first down. You saw Adam Utalski leave the field with an injury moments ago. For FreeCreditReport.com sideline report, more from Jim Knox.
All right, Bill, looks at it. He had elbow and knee problems last year. That elbow is a little bit weak, obviously.
Been a frequent winner of the Boss Hog Award they give to their offensive lineman around here in big leagues. So that is a big miss for UT on the offensive side of the football. Carry out to the 50-yard line, and that'll be a first down here for Texas as Mondrell McGee that time showing good speed and power. And Texas right at midfield, first and 10. McGee.
Texas averaging over 5 yards a carry, Bill. Almost six, 20 carries, 117 yards. They're getting it cranked a little bit.
McCoy looking to throw it here, and it is complete to Kirkendall again. Kirk covering on the sideline. Colt McCoy for 4 touchdown passes today. He's thrown 11 TD passes in his career against Baylor. He's also gone for big yardage in the year today.
Well, that was just an outstanding timing between quarterback and receiver. Colt McCoy plants the last step of his drop. The ball is already in the air. The ball is in the air before Kirkendall turns around to find it, and it's right on the money between the ones on his jersey.
13 yards on that pickup. McGee hops across the line and then gets hit hard, but picks up a couple of yards. And McCoy is also pass plays of 10 or more yards today. 11 times he has completed it for first down passing. Havlick making the tackle on that last play. McCoy 21 of 31 for 242, 4 TDs and the 2 interceptions.
Continues to play at an exceptionally high level. You know, his Heisman hopeful season is certainly not over as well. Still remains a very strong candidate for the Heisman.
Caught. Shoved out of bounds here by Burke. And there's a play where Colts probably learned a little bit as the season's run on too, Dave. I think season opener, he might have ducked his shoulder under it, see if I'm going to get an extra yard. But at this point, hey, you picked up a nice game, get out of bounds.
And I think too, Bill, he's taking some shots today. You know, he's been knocked around a little bit. We showed the grass stains on his back of his pants. His jersey showed the hit that he had a little whiplash after the touchdown pass he threw. So I think he's going to be smarter on how many hits he takes the rest of the day.
Third and 3. And on the football. Close to the first down. We'll see where they spot the ball.
Well, this on third, on fourth and short, does Mack kick it? There it is, he go. He's very quickly decided he's going to load up with the big people, and he's going to go for it on fourth down. He brings in Peter Ullman, the big tight end, as an extra big body up front.
Yeah, Ullman and Smith, both big body tight ends, come in there and listen, Chip. Shipley wide to the top of your screen, and then Cosby. McCoy is going to keep it. Didn't need much. Appears to have it as he steps across.
But in these situations on third or fourth and short, always starts with the big boys up front. And they get off the line of scrimmage pretty decently on that play. And give Colt McCoy. He hesitates a little bit. Snap. Decides where to go. He curls back to his left, found some opportunity to slither in there. Nice job up front by the big fellas, not allowing Baylor to rehog up underneath him and knock him backwards.
First and 10 at the 26 now. A 2-yard pickup by McCoy. Here he is again, shedding tacklers, and again, turns out of bounds on that Baylor sideline. Pressured that time by Leon Freeman. Freeman, one of the older players in the Big 12, 25 after starting his college career, following service time in the Army, 6 months in Iraq, Mesa Community College out in Arizona.
I'll tell you, Art Briles, we just got a good look at right there, is one of the better communicators I've ever listened to, because he has a great message and he delivers it with just the right touch of humor. And that keeps his players' attention.
McCoy still on his feet. How he hung on to the football there as he got knocked around like he was in bumper cars as Pavlik made the final stop.
And Johnson was in there smacking people around as well. Colt McCoy is going to be in the jacuzzi tonight. He'll be a sore young man. Decides to turn up the football field and he gets jackknifed. I mean, pretty good action by the Baylor Bears. There's no quitting those guys. Baylor's going to fight you every snap. No matter what the score, no matter what time it is left in the game, they're coming after you.
He picked up 7, McCoy. It's a 3rd and 3 from the 19. 7-11 in third down conversions today. Fozzie Whitaker. Another close to that first down marker. Freeman was there to stop for the Baylor Bears. Baylor 3-6, 1-4 in the league. They still have Texas A&M and at Tech to go. Longhorns at Kansas next week before they finish up Thanksgiving. Texas A&M.
And Texas decided to go for it on fourth and short once again. They want to play keep away. They want to control time of possession to keep the Baylor Bears explosive Griffin on the sideline. We see defensive coordinator Brian Norwood checking it out.
Fourth and one, and timeout Texas.
Texas, first timeout.
They'll visit here. We'll take a break. 3:54 to go in the third. Longhorns threatening again with a 35-14 lead. Eleventh play of the drive coming up for Texas. It is a big one. Fourth and one at the 17 of Baylor. Longhorns with 3:54 to go in the third quarter. Time-consuming, grinded-out drive. They got Johnson as a fullback. McCoy will keep. And once again, appears a forward progress that he made it to first down territory. Colt, as you mentioned, Dave, he has taken some serious shots today.
Yeah, Colt, when you're a Heisman Trophy candidate, there's a target on you. He got drilled right there, a little whiplash action, drilled again, potential whiplash on the safety blitz. Everybody wants a piece of Colt McCoy. You know, he could be the 2008 Heisman Trophy winner, and you want to say, I got a lick on him. And Baylor, everybody on their defense seems to be wanting to do exactly that. Colt McCoy showing some toughness mentally and physically.
Picked up two on that carry. First and 10 from the 15 as he hands it off this time. And there's not much running room for Fozzie Whitaker that time.
Whitaker, that's his 14th carry of the day. He's well over 70 yards. Texas has rushed the ball for almost 140 yards on the day.
Whitaker, freshman out of Pearland, Texas, and number six all-time high school rushing. 5,700 yards, 51 touchdowns in his high school career. And it's taken till this game in the season to really get him where they feel he's pretty much 100% healthy. But impressive today. 10, McCoy. Rodgers one, wide open, touchdown Texas. His roommate, Jordan Shipley, another TD reception, 15 yards on the play. And McCoy to Shipley, a common phrase around here, as Texas puts on another six, and McCoy gets his season best fifth touchdown pass of the day.
And he's got 12 against the Baylor Bears, and he's got 11 on the season with Shipley. Coming into today, they were tied for third in the Big 12, hooking up 10 times. Make that 11 now, and they do know each other well.
Hunter Lawrence for the PAT. Yeah, the only pair ahead of them, Zach Robinson to Des Bryant, and Graham Harrell to Michael Crabtree, OSU and Texas duos.
Watch the patience and poise of Colt McCoy, and Shipley just stays alive. Finds a little opening. Says, I know eventually he's going to get his eyes to me. He always does. And he did. Shipley rewarding Colt McCoy for the poise and patience.
Shipley has had some season. Here's a quick look at some of the highlights with the Rice game being among the best. Arkansas, a pair of touchdowns on eight receptions. Oklahoma, no one will forget that one, certainly, with the TD in the reception and the 96-yard kickoff return. In Dallas against Missouri, 8 for 89. Oklahoma State, a phenomenal game. 15 receptions, 169 yards. And the big victory over the Cowboys. And Texas Tech, a punt return of 45 yards for a score. And the narrow loss to the Red Raiders. So Shipley, his 11th receiving touchdown, but his 13th touchdown of the season overall.
Shipley is one of four guys to return a punt and a kickoff in his career. And he's one of two guys to do it in the same season. Punt return and kickoff return.
Baker, the 20, upended near the 25, fumble. Baylor maintained possession.
That's the fourth fumble Baylor has put on the ground. They haven't lost any of them. They've played with dynamite four times. And this is just a good hit right on the football. I mean, you just lay the shoulder pad right on the football. Acho does. The ball's recovered by Baylor. four times, and they get every single one of them back.
Jake Lamar is the one that recovered that one. It's already a tough enough situation with the Bears. 2:52 to go in the third, and four straight touchdowns by Texas. Griffin trying to make it up. Wants a block. He's at the 50, the 40. Griffin will turn it on. The 20. Robert Griffin down the sideline, dragged out of bounds near the 11-yard line.
Well, he almost outran the angle of Blake Gideon, but Gideon showed some giddy up, and he ran him down. Boy, Griffin is special in space. He comes down the football field with the option. He makes his mind up immediately. Now he's saying, get me one downfield block, and he got it, takes it inside. Gideon just had enough of an angle to take him to the turf. Outstanding effort by Griffin, giving him 100 yards rushing in the game.
His longest run of the season of 63 yards. He seems better than his 58-yarder that was previously his best. And now Baylor, Sanders on the carry, his first of the day. Sanders had come in with 30 carries, averaging 3.8 a tote, and one touchdown.
Griffin has been dynamite on the ground, 114 yards, average on 11 carries, averaging a first down every time he carries the football, over 10 yards a carry and a touchdown. Struggled in the air, though, 5 of 16 with an interception, 73 yards passing.
That's been the problem today. He rolls out here under pressure once again, coming back to try to dive and catch the football as Geddes a little short of it. Griffin, ninth in the league in rushing per game at 65 yards and having a great day running today. Well, there's a reason he's a good runner, because graduated from high school in December of last year, enrolls at Baylor, and immediately in the spring of 07, the Big 12 400 meter champ, and went on to compete, finished third in the NCAAs.
Now you have to have a dog gut to run the 400 meter hurdles, and he has it.
Griffin here, gonna scoot in the end zone. Yes, touchdown Baylor, and a flag is thrown. I think it's gonna be against the Bears.
Yeah,
that's in the backfield.
Big Miller says we got a hold going on here. Take it back. Big Roy Miller says that one's gonna be nullified. Still first down, and Art Briles incredulously looking on, saying, how can we do that? How can you make that call? How can we shoot ourselves in the foot? Let's see if who the call ends up being on. Is it? I'm not sure who they're going to call that one on. It could have been on anybody inside, and Griffin got to the outside on the perimeter, and he is a threat once he gets to the edge. I mean, very few people in the country are going to be able to run with Griffin. I mean, the times that he had, Big 12 champion in the hurdles. He was third in the nation. He won the regional in that 400-meter hurdles. Just an incredibly powerful guy to finish those races.
Third and 24, and a flag here before this one gets underway.
Third and 29 now.
Dead ball foul. False start. Number 78 of the offense. Penalty 5 yards, and it's still third down.
We make the call on anybody. Greaseback is the guy that gets the call right here, but they're the June Taylor dancers early on the left side. They were totally choreographed. Had great footwork, but it was before the snap of the football.
They average 7 penalties a game for 55 yards. They've had 7 today for 74 yards. And we've still got 2:11 to go in the third quarter. Now they're pushed back to a third and 29 at the 30-yard line.
The holding penalty took points off the board, took Griffin's touchdown off the board.
Here's Griffin again in trouble and brought down. A sack on the play as the Longhorn defense cranks it up, knowing he's in a passing situation, and Miller is there again.
Miller's a man inside. It's hard to single block Miller. He gets after it. Check out the big fella, Roy Miller. They run a little twist, and he's the looper, and he's looping big, and nobody's on Miller, and Miller finishes it. They ran a little tackle twist. Penetrator does a nice job of taking two blockers up, Aaron Lewis, and Miller, when he loops around that penetrator, came clean.
So fourth down and 36 from the 37-yard line. And another whistle here.
Fourth down and 36.
Dead ball foul. Delay of game by number 10 of the offense. Oh. 5-yard penalty. It's still fourth down.
Fourth down and 41. and you can still get a first down at the 1 yard line.
Yeah, how about that, huh? I don't think we've had many of those. I wonder what Art Briles has got in the playbook for 4th and 41.
Yeah, if I'm the coach and a player looks at me for 4th and 41, I fold my arms and turn my back. I don't know. What do you think? Whatever you think is good enough for me. I don't have many 4th and 41 plays in here.
Well, they were down at the 11-yard line when it appeared that Griffin scampered into the end zone and the penalty fest started. Here they go, 4th and 41, and Kendall Wright at the 35 and stop there.
Kendall Wright had another receiver on the sideline that he was debating pitching the football to, but could not quite pull the trigger. And Coach Art Briles on the field talking to the officials about his dissatisfaction with some of the calls in that sequence. But watch, he's taking a look. He had a receiver right behind him, right here, who he was thinking about utilizing to pitch the football to. That's Jeremy Sanders.
Texas gets it on downs now. They dodge a bullet after the 63-yard run by Griffin had set him up to score, and then he was in the end zone. And the penalties took one away. They're able to Texas withstand all of that. And McCoy to Cosby. Devon Cosby, 35 and the 40-yard line. Cosby and Shipley running up some serious career numbers for these two seniors. Cosby had come in with 2,166 yards career-wise, and Shipley 1,425 in yardage. Both have been big factors again today.
Cosby, 7 catches, 109 yards, 2 touchdowns. And it was debatable how much he was going to be able to play today with that back injury.
McCoy to Williams. And Williams forges ahead for the first down. 47-yard line. Chris Burke makes the stop there. Malcolm Williams was last week when Cosby went out. He came up big after not being used much prior to that.
Yeah, he had his breakout game, and this was a big play. Watch Colt McCoy pump fake, and then he's going to throw the football up for Williams. Williams ran a little stutter step, a little double move action. Texas Tech bit big time. That was a point in the game where I thought, maybe Texas can come back and take a lead in this thing and win it.
Yeah, 91 yards on that play, 182 on the day. And a slight delay here.
He ran a great route, and the defensive back got caught looking at Colt McCoy in the backfield, and Williams just double-moved him to death.
Final play of the quarter, Whitaker. And that ends the third period here in Austin, Texas. The fourth-ranked Texas Longhorns were tied at 14. It's been all Longhorns here in the second half, though. 42-14, that's the end of the third quarter. You're watching Big 12 College Football Saturday. It's presented by KFC. Bevo taking a seat here, enjoying this one as Texas a lead of 42-14. We start the fourth quarter, our KFC game summary. It was tight for a while, but Colt McCoy has overcome 2 interceptions with a season-high 5 TD passes. Griffin doing much of his work on the ground. Palmer, a pick for a score. And McCoy, no mistakes here in the third quarter.
Roy Miller's come up big today with a couple of quarterback sacks for the defensive side of the football. Billy only had 1 sack coming in.
Yeah, we talked about Baylor's balance. They haven't been able to establish it today, and McCoy goes back to work here. And a wide open Shipley, 25, and down near the 23-yard line, Jordan Shipley out of Burnet, Texas, and Jeremy Williams making the stop.
Jordan Shipley, it's kind of like, where's Waldo? Where's Shipley? He's been inside, he's been outside, he's been all over the field. This time, he's inside, and the field is stretched by his compatriot, Malcolm Williams, and Shipley just breaks into the sideline. Williams took a couple of defenders deep with him. Shipley benefited, broke his run off. McCoy found it.
28 on the pickup, 6 for 81 on the day for Shipley. McCoy, and her eyes in the back of his head. He throws this one away as he is shoved.
Call that.
And there are flags fluttering everywhere.
Colt McCoy takes another hit, but he gets up and keeps on kicking strong. Leon Freeman with the late hit there.
Roughing the passer, number 49 of the defense.
penalty pass the distance to the goal, and it's a first down.
You know, it's you have to know where you are on the football field, lost track of where he was. And the penalty will give the Longhorns a first down at the 12-yard line.
First and 10 at the 11-yard line after that play, and Texas with 14:26 to go. You see the career 300-yard passing games, and McCoy just a couple of yards here to keep moving up on the record charts. Cosby
might have gotten it.
Yeah. No, he's going to just try to get it exactly.
Yeah.
Because Jake LaBar makes the stop. And that'll do it. There's Major. Boy, they're glad to have him back in Austin and a vital part of the staff.
As he was playing quarterback here, he's doing exactly what I thought he would do. He was basically a coach on the field. Now that his playing days are over, he's in the profession he should be in.
On the ground, down inside the 5-yard line, Mondrell McGee. The third down and 2 coming up. Texas trying to punch in another one here, up 42-14. Third 2 at the 3-yard line. McCoy has McGee with him in the backfield. McCoy got time, waiting, and incomplete. Nearly picked off there. Pavelic in the end zone, the linebacker for Baylor. Closest one to receiving that football.
Colt McCoy might have been able to tuck this one and walk into the end zone, but he decides to keep it alive and throw the football. I mean, obviously the guy that he saw that was bothering him was Antonio Johnson, the linebacker. And I think Colt could have at least gotten a first down. It could have been first and goal at the 1-yard line, but decides to throw the football and doesn't come up with the play. Field goal opportunity.
Means Hunter Lawrence will come on for the field goal. He's 9 of 9 this year. Hadn't missed an extra point. And oh,
with the left upper.
There is the miss. So perfection no more for Hunter Lawrence, the 6-foot, 185-pound junior from Bernie, Texas. Longhorn lead stays at 28-42-14. You're watching College Football Saturday here in Austin. We'll take a brief timeout. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Austin. 12:58 remaining here with Texas up 42-14. Lawrence missing on the field goal attempt, and Baylor gets the football back. First to 10 from the 20-yard line. Bill Land, Dave Lapham, Jim Knox with you here in Austin at Darrell K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium. Griffin throws it out on the flank and lost on the play. And Wright nowhere to go after making that grab.
You know what Art Browse does is just his formations are so dynamic and creative. He spreads you out so much. That time he ran a bunch formation, like a little triangle of wide receivers all the way in front of the Texas sideline, then had two receivers out to the other side. I mean, he takes you from sideline to sideline horizontally with his formation, then throws the ball over your head and stretches you vertically.
Griffin. Running out of room here and simply steps out of bounds. Loss on the play there with a flag as well.
Usually in the interior, it's
personal foul, leg whip. Ooh. On number 71 of the offense. Penalties half the distance to the goal and replay second down.
That never used to be a foul, a leg whip. And Dan Gay, you know, it used to be when you were going to the ground, the last resort was to get your legs up there and kick them in the shins, try to take them to the turf. And it was coached in the National Football League for a bunch of years. Leg whip was not illegal. Texas declined the penalty. They've got Baylor off schedule. looked like he said declined it, didn't he?
Yeah, third and 18.
Right.
And dire straits as it is, and Griffin, 6 of 18 in the air for 71 yards. He has certainly been contained in the passing game. Came in with 1,688 yards passing, and 22nd in the nation in passing efficiency.
You wanted this, you can understand why Texas said, make him beat us with his arm.
Yeah. Time here, and finds a man, and simply dropped right across the middle by Jay Finley. It's kind of been the way of Baylor ever since they tied the game at 14, that nothing's gone their way, even when they've had the golden opportunity.
Absolutely, and you know, Griffin has shown himself capable on the ground, 101 yards rushing, but they've struggled throwing the football all day, and Griffin says, man, it's just Murphy's Law. It's just the way it's going today. It's just not our day in the air. There's no doubt about that.
So they'll put this one away. Epperson stands in his own end zone, and Shipley is at the 45-yard line of Texas. Shipley, a chance to return here. The 45, 50, 40. And Texas, another great scoring opportunity as Shipley takes it down near the 32-yard line. And the Longhorns, after a 23-yard return, are pretty good shape once again.
Shipley very, very clever in space. Gives his offense a short field.
One of the biggest moments in this storied rivalry game, November 9, 1963, here at Memorial Stadium. Number one, Texas, a 7-0 lead late in the game. Baylor's heralded quarterback Don Troll led the Bears downfield. But Duke Carlisle of Texas intercepted Troll's pass. Horns held on to win their eighth straight game and eventually went on to win the national title. I recall you old-timers, Carlisle was also the Horns' starting quarterback. Darrell K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium. National championships recently, of course, 05. John Childs, the new quarterback for Texas, the 6'2", 250-pound sophomore from Dallas, and replacing McCoy, hands it off here. Childs has run for a score this season, passed for two. He's 10 of 11 in the passing game with 140 yards on the year. He's run it 34 times, though. Early this season, they were using a little bit different package where they sometimes utilize Childs and McCoy in the field at the same time.
Just slash. Huh?
Yeah, just didn't have the cue package. It just didn't have the kind of success that they're hoping, and pretty much have phased that out in the most recent games. Childs here. Great feet. Runs it to the 26-yard line. That'll be a third down coming up for the Texas Longhorns. As for Colt McCoy, appears that he's done for the day with a season-high 5 touchdown passes.
Like you talked about, all those grass stains in the back, that's why they're taking him out.
Yeah.
A lot of hits. 300 yards. But it's okay if your quarterback has grass stains on the front of his uniform. When they're on the back of his uniform, that means he's been taken to the turf by the defense. And on the front, it's because he's running and sliding and diving. You don't want him on the back.
Third and 3 at the 25. Childs. Close to a first down. Checking with Jim Knox, freecreditreport.com, sideline report.
All right.
Well, what about Graham Harrell, Texas Tech would say, huh? What about Crabtree, if you want to stay in the Big 12? Sam Bradford. There's a lot of people out there having great years.
There are.
And many of them in this conference. McGee and DeCarry here. Down to the 20. Dave, it may come down to the winningest team with the best player.
And what's going to happen is they're going to take votes from each other. All these guys from this region, other than Tebow, but these four right here.
I would agree.
They're all going to start splitting votes up. Tebow may benefit because all these guys are going to start to split the votes. And will that be the case? I don't know. I mean, I think that Colt McCoy is a more than worthy candidate, as is Graham Harrell, as is Bradford. Crabtree. It's alive for all of us. There's much football to be played.
Don't forget Des Bryant. Saw the name down at the bottom with 15 touchdown receptions. So it's going to be a great finish, not only with the team-wise for the BCS, but obviously for the awards and particularly the Heisman leading the way.
And the thing about Colt McCoy, Graham Harrell, we know Tebow, all these guys are great representatives for college football, not just on the football field, but off the football field. They're taking care of business in the classroom. I mean, they're solid citizens through and through, and that's what the Heisman Trophy, you know, really, really looks to. That's not the reason to get it. When you get that as an added benefit, it's a big plus for the Heisman people.
Second and seven at the 14. Childs, nice little jitter, and then shows you some muscle. Rolling across the 10 to the 9, and Tristan Hill making the tackle.
Dan Buckner had a great block on the edge in the perimeter. Watch number four in the orange jersey right here. You see it. And seal the edge. And now you got a guy who can make you miss, you know, with the little jackhammer feet on the perimeter, Childs. But wide receivers for Texas done a good job blocking today.
They look there at Buckner, the freshman out of Allen, Texas, the suburb of Dallas. First and goal to go from the 9-yard line. Childs there a little bit, and as a result, nice run for the Horns inside the five. Leon Freeman leading the defensive charge.
Right, Bill, what Childs gives you in your running game is every time they run the inside zone like they did right there in the offensive line area blocks, he can keep it. If he sees the backside defensive end crashing inside, he'll keep the football and run right around him. So he makes the running lanes wider, because he'll give you an option the opposite side, coming out the back door, holding onto the football. Puts a lot of pressure on those defensive ends.
Cody Johnson with the carry that time for 4 yards. You see domination of Texas yardage carry situation. And Childs fakes to Johnson this time. Back hard, and they're trying to push him into the end zone. It's like a little rugby there, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Childs shows you some of his strength, though.
I don't think you have a starter left up front, basically, with the offensive line. Texas has basically emptied their bench. You know, everybody's getting an opportunity to play here, and Art Briles is imploring his football team to continue to play hard. And that, I think that's something that he's done, changing the culture a little bit, is no matter what, go out and play every snap like it's your last snap of your career. Play every snap as hard as you possibly can.
Whistles here before we get underway with a timeout called, and it's by Texas. We'll take a break for the Longhorns trying to get another TD up 42-14. Knocking on the door again here in Austin with 6:26 to go, and the Horns facing a third and goal from the 2. With the 9 quickly in motion there behind Childs, the quarterback. Childs loses the football. McGee picks it up, and he is hit for a loss on the play. A wave of Baylor tacklers come through on that busted play as Antonio Jones leading the way.
Well, you got to get the center quarterback exchange. That's elementary, and that has to occur. That sometimes happens with lack of game time experience. Now, you know, did the quarterback pull out of there too soon? Did the center not get the ball back far enough? Those are the things that have to be worked out, but you got to get it right.
So fourth down and goal to go from the 13, and Lawrence will come on for the field goal attempt from the 30-yard line. Punter over to Ryan Bailey. And this one is good. Ryan Bailey, senior from Austin, gets the field goal, and it's his first field goal of the year. Back in Austin here on a beautiful afternoon, and Texas has turned it into that for the Longhorn fans after being tied at 14 at one point. Horns with that 30-yard field goal from Bailey, now with a 45-14 lead. And Justin Tucker will kick it off. Once again, Baker, this time at the 7 for the Baylor Bears. 30, 35, the Jets are on, and down the sideline he goes. He is knocked out of bounds near the 30-yard line of Texas. Let's go to Mike Goldberg for a game break. All right, Mike, we look forward to that. Thank you much. 49-yard return here by Baker, and Baylor will have it first and 10 at the 44. On the ground, the Bears keep it on this first play. Number 32, Jay Finley, the ball carrier. Well, Texas has lived up to its average since the Big 12 began. Longhorns have averaged 44.6 versus Baylor. That's the third highest scoring average in the league for one team against another. And Texas with 45 today has fit the bill again. And not only that, Texas last year won 31-10. They've now, if they complete this one, would win 11 straight.
Whoa, see it.
Finley says, put 7 on the board for Baylor. Just like that. 40-yard scamper for Jay Finley. He gets his 6th TD of the year, and the excitement is not over yet here in Austin.
You got to like the never-say-die attitude of the Baylor Bears. I mean, Baker takes the kickoff back, kickoff return 49 yards to give a short field, and they keep the ball on the ground. Excellent blocking up front. And I'll tell you, that's an outstanding effort by Jay Finley. And there's no question Baylor can rush the football. I mean, on the ground today, they've got 201 yards rushing on 29 carries.
Finley's 40-yard run. Ben Parks with a PAT. And it's 45-21.
It's just a counter. They pull the off guard and off tackle, and they both get through the hole easily, as does Finley. And then he just runs right through everybody. He scores in touch football. Never mind tackle football. Nobody laid a fingernail on him.
Baylor fans, something to cheer about here in the second half after Texas domination. Scoring drive, 2 plays, 44 yards. Robert Griffin today
went deep to Kendall Wright for 55 yards. So 55 of 71 yards were on that pass.
So Texas to get the football back here with 4:58 to go. Parks to kick it away. Williams and Scott are deep. And it goes to Malcolm Williams. 20, 25. Williams put a good return in his own right across the 30 to the 33. Hey, big happening weekend around here in Austin. Royal Memorial Stadium opened in 1924 as a symbol of remembrance of fallen veterans of war. Yesterday, a ceremony held to rededicate the stadium following the expansion of the North End Zone. Frank Denius, a decorated veteran of World War II, later earned his degree in business and law at Texas, was honored with the naming of the new Frank Denius Veterans Memorial Plaza. Done a fantastic job here of making this place bigger, better, yet still remembering those great veterans. And thus, Gerald K. Royal Texas Memorial Stadium is now capacity 98,000.
Cody Johnson on the carry.
Ball on the ground for Texas as Johnson carries it here, the redshirt freshman out of Waller, Texas.
Just an amazing edifice here right now. I mean, the expansion that's taken place in terms of number of seats, more seats for Mac Brown has been phenomenal. I mean, obviously, he's been on a nice run. Darrell Royal, Mac Brown, two great eras of Texas football.
They've been averaging 97,998 here. When Dave showed up, they said, oh, that'll put us at 98. Thank you, sir.
Johnson
again, the ball carrier, a second down situation. First down markers brought to you by Overstock.com. Overstock.com's prices are so low, you can afford to buy something for your friends, too. Overstock.com at home with the O.
You know, another trend that's going to continue today, fortunately for Texas and unfortunately for Baylor, since 96, Big 12 home games, Texas will now be 41-5, over 90% winning percentage. Baylor, 2-49, which is obviously a struggling mode on the road in the Big 12.
Yeah, that's certainly in the line of things to get done for respect for the coaching staff at Baylor, led by Art Briles, is you've got to win some conference games, you've got to start winning them on the road,
yep,
and then it becomes a whole different deal. But Art Briles, who aren't aware from this state, 4 state titles while the high school coach at Stephenville in 12 years, and then quickly turned Houston around. and went 34-28 in his 5 years there. Took him to four bowls in those 5 years. And there is no doubt with the facilities boom at Baylor as well. In fact, they just announced they will have an indoor facility. It's going to be funded to get underway soon. They'll become competitive in that area as well. Childs on the keeper here to give him the first down.
Well, you know, Art Briles is in the process of changing the culture. You know, he wants to get Baylor and all the alums excited and stay excited, change their mindset, their attitudes. You know, he's all about faith, beliefs, hope, reason to believe. And he's going to get it done. I mean, I think he's an outstanding leader and communicator with that dry wit that he has. I mean, he mixes humor in with message as well as anybody I've ever met.
220 and counting. Second and one from the 47-yard line. Hills, Jeremy Hills, freshman from Houston out of Leif Elsick High School with the carry. Texas trying to run it out here with a 45-21 lead and 2:09 to go. For those of you watching on Northwest and Bay Area, you'll be leaving our game in a moment for your next live event. We will update you with the final score of this game. Longhorns trying to go 9-1 and 5-1 in the Big 12.
Matt Brown being happy about the rebound performance of his football team today.
Bills again with the carry down inside the 40 of Baylor. And it'll be second down coming up. Texas, what a grind they've been through, Dave. And Coach Brown was talking to us this week about the challenge facing the team to, after having had win or lose, he said this game was going to be tough, and because Baylor was good enough to beat them if they didn't have their act together. Nice that they actually have a little fourth quarter breather here as Childs may take this one to the house. 25-20, breaks a tackle, touchdown Texas. A flag is thrown at the 35-yard line.
Once he broke the tackle of Jordan Lake, he was gone, but it's going to come
holding
back.
Number 31 of the offense. Penalty is 10 yards, and replay second down.
Cody Johnson, that's the second hold that's taken a rushing touchdown for the quarterback off the board. Griffin had one taken off. Now Childs does.
Another look at it here.
And here's, here he is right here with the lead blocking. There it is. He pulled a tackle on him. He not only blocked, he wrapped his hands around his ankle and took him to the ground. And unnecessarily so, didn't have to do it.
Well, my point on Texas, even within a game, to have a little bit of a breather at this point, rest some people, get some other people some playing time, because gauntlet again.
Yeah.
Number 11 and number 16, depending on the ranking of Kansas, and then A&M, who has had their number the last year or two.
Yeah, they haven't beaten A&M the last two seasons, so you have to treat it as another mini gauntlet.
Here is Childs. Flag thrown in as he crosses midfield. He's at third and 16. So the Big 12, there are no off days.
Holding, number 31 of the offense. At least 10 yards, and replay second down.
Two consecutive holding calls on the same player. I've can't recall ever seeing that, honestly. Back-to-back holding calls on Cody Johnson. Going to move Texas back another distance. Look at it for Baylor, A&M, and Texas Tech. And Baylor's had as tough a schedule as anybody. I mean, you know, that's another factor. Art Briles realizes that in the Big 12 South, you've got four of the top nine teams in the BCS playing in your division of your conference. You talk about tough. I mean, that's tough duty right there.
31 seconds to go, and Childs keeping the football here gets smothered. Yeah, A&M with Oklahoma today, College Station, and Mike Sherman doing a nice job of picking up the pieces there. That'll end it. That'll be the final play as Texas, fourth ranked in the country BCS-wise, bounces back from the loss to Texas Tech last week, and a heartbreaker it was in Lubbock. They win convincingly here, 45-21. They took a 28-14 halftime lead and quickly dominated in the third quarter to win 45-21. And as a result, that Big 12 South, the toughest division in all of college football. You see those four teams all ranked in the top nine of the nation. Texas goes to 5-1. And we'll wait and see what happens with Texas Tech and Oklahoma State a little bit later on. Let's set it down to Jim Knox.
All right, thank you, Bill. Coach, congratulations. You know, after the schedule you guys played, Oklahoma, Oklahoma State, Missouri, they keep coming at you, and you try to get up for a Baylor team early morning start. You came out a little flat, understandably so, but you got to be happy your team put in high gear after the 14-0.
Jim, I didn't think we came out flat. We got 14 quick points, and give Baylor some credit here, too. They've got a really good football team, nearly beat Missouri last week, had Nebraska on the ropes the week before, and Robert Griffin's as advertised. He's really a good football player, but proud of our guys. We got a lot we can still improve on, but sitting here at 9-1, we got a chance. We just got to keep playing.
And you like the position you're in right now, don't you?
Well, I do. I'd rather be 10-0, but we're sitting in a good place. We just got to keep playing.
All right, appreciate it. Congratulations, Mac. Bill?
All right, thank you very much. Last year they go 10-3. They're now 9-1, 5-1 in the Big 12. Colt McCoy, 5 touchdown passes, a season high for Colt McCoy, as Texas, a 45-21 winner over the Baylor Bears. Our college football Saturday triple header will continue next, as Stanford will be meeting Oregon from the Pac-10, followed by Kansas State at Missouri, the Big 12 in Columbia. This is Bill Land for Dave Lapham and Jim Knox saying so long from Austin here at Darrell K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium. The Texas Longhorns handed to the Baylor Bears 45-21, our final score. You've been watching Big 12 College Football Saturday presented by KFC.
Hi, it's Finn.